Cassidy Khan seems to be as healthy as any other diver at Indiana University.
We train about 4 hours a day, 6 days a week. I practice with the team and I compete with the team. We travel within the conference competing against other Big Ten teams.
But Cassidy is actually very different from many other student athletes. For 3 years, she's been overcoming a singular experience. And still last year, she didn't think she would be able to dive again. Originally from New York, Cassidy came to Indiana University in the fall of 2007 to be a freshman on the diving team. She had high expectations for her first season as a Hoosier, but she faced an unexpected illness in her legs.
Basically, my legs started hurting one weekend in February of my freshman year. It started out as a rash and pain and some swelling.
But there was more than an apparent bug bite. On that Wednesday, at the Bloomington Hospital, Cassidy was sent right away to emergency surgery. She was diagnosed with necrotizing fasciitis, an infection caused by a flesh-eating bacteria.
They asked me what religion I was, and I said Jewish, and they said, we're going to bring in a rabbi.
According to the surgeons, if Cassidy had gotten to the hospital 2 hours later, she probably wouldn't have made it through the night.
The mortality rate of necrotizing fasciitis is about 70-80%. I mean, the fact that I'm here today and the fact that I have my legs is incredible. It's a miracle.
Cassidy underwent 13 surgeries in both of her legs, and she was unable to dive for 2 years and a half.
I think after we knew that I was going to be okay, I just wanted my life back.
Cassidy had to take one step at a time, and doing rehab was a physical and a mental challenge.
That was hard. That was devastating. I came in every single day, and I watched them train. I mean, I would have killed to be in their spot. I would have done anything to be able to dive.
Right now, Cassidy is a junior, and she comes back to the diving board that she's been missing for so long. She eventually gets to compete in college as a Hoosier on the diving team, which has been her dream for her entire life.
For her first collegiate competition, Cassidy got to dive in front of her home crowd for the Hoosierland Invitational last November. Even if she didn't finish in the top places, being able to participate was a great accomplishment for Cassidy. So how does it feel to be back to diving?
Oh my gosh. There's no words to describe the feeling of being back. I think there's every single feeling that I could have, excitement. I mean, I'm diving, I'm doing what I want to do. I live and breathe for diving.
Cassidy's battle against illness and her comeback to the highest level of diving is a great lesson of life for our teammates and coaches.
It's really awesome to have someone that has that much spirit and drive to be diving. Every time you're having a bad day and you're like, oh, I don't want to be here. But then you see her and you're like, oh, you know, if she's still diving and still here, I think I want to be here. This is a good place to be.
Cassidy brings a lot to our team. Even when she wasn't diving, I think she served as an inspiration, a model for mental toughness, a model for perseverance, never giving up.
For Cassidy, she couldn't have come back without the support of her loved ones.
The people that were there for me, my friends, my family, I owe so much to them because they stuck by me. They helped me through the struggles. I mean, there's so much credit that has to be given to them.
The evidence of our fight is visible, but for Cassidy Khan, a new life has begun, and she hopes to keep doing what she loves for many more years. From Bloomington, Indiana, I'm Miriam Sopel.